You know, say we're in the end times. We can't make any excuses. We can still stand. You know, if we seek God, He will react. We can provoke the Lord. Just like in the book of Acts when they were persecuted. Acts chapter 5, they got together and they said, Lord, you know, we thank the Lord that we've been persecuted for your name. You know, they thanked the Lord for it, that we got to be persecuted for your name. And they asked the Lord to do miracles in the name of his holy child, Jesus. And it says the place was shaken. It's really the first revival in the Bible. It's about 3 years after the day of Pentecost. God shook the place. The place was filled with the Spirit, just like on the day of Pentecost. And that's what I pray we have. I know we've got people at totally different levels here. People with all different kinds of things. That's why I'm asking you. Whatever agenda you have, whatever theological ideas you have to try to, you know, push forward. God didn't call us to push forward that. You know, like when I go to the Philippines, I used to go to areas that were controlled by communist rebels and Muslim rebels. And I would go. And they hadn't seen a non-Filipino since World War II. It was Americans. The Marines came through there in World War II. My dad had an uncle that was there, and the Raiders, they call it. It's like before the Special Forces, had some kind of Marine. Raiders. So my great uncle was there in the same place where I was at, Mindanao Island, southern island of the Philippines. And everybody was like, we can't believe you're going to go, you're going to go. I said, well, yeah, Lord will make a way. It's my time. It's up to the Lord. Because the Lord was leading me to go. I wasn't going just to test the Lord. The Lord was leading me to go. So I went to these places. You had to walk for like 3 days to get there. You couldn't even drive a motorcycle there. You could maybe go on some kind of a mountain goat or something, right? I don't know. But everybody walked. It took 3 days to get to these different one place. Another place was 2 days from there. I went to all these places, and the only pastors that would go were Baptist preachers. And the Pentecostal pastors were telling me, you're going to go with the Baptist preachers, and they won't even pray with us because they don't believe in the gifts of the Spirit. I was like, look, the Philippines is less than 10% born again. The Baptist preachers are evangelizing these people. These people went to the first or second grade. They can't hardly read and write. They don't even know who Jesus is. We don't need to talk about them being filled with the Spirit and discipleship and all that. They need to get saved first. You got to go there and evangelize them first. So, you know, that's why I went with those people. It don't matter what denomination somebody's from. If they're going to go to lost people, I'm going to go with them. I don't care who goes. I'm not going to let, you know, they were arguing amongst themselves. Whoever wants to go with me, I'm going with me. Let's go. You know, let's win these people to the Lord. So that's what it's all about, brothers and sisters. The Bible says, Romans 8:28, God causes all things to work together for the good of those who love Him, who are called according to His purposes. So God has a plan and a purpose to get the people that work in this hotel saved, if they're not saved, all the people walking around here saved, and He wants to use Christians to do it. That's us. So while we're not doing that, you know, we can force ourselves to do it, but we can also be empowered by the Spirit and led by the Spirit, and God would open a door and lead you to pray with somebody without you doing it. God can open that door. That's where the Spirit of God comes in. He prepares that person's heart in advance. You know, God's been dealing with them about something for days, and all of a sudden you walk up, and then the Lord leads you into it to start talking to them about the very problem they've got. That's how God works. That's what this is all about. Jesus came to seek and save the lost. That's always the mission with the Lord, to bring glory to His name, for people to get saved. That's the bottom line. But when people have revivals, they do evangelism. Revival is not for evangelism. Evangelism is a fruit of revival. And we would get on fire to go out and win people. The world's out there, not in here. We need to go out there and win those people. And we need to be empowered and equipped and surrendered to do it. I deal with people every day, they want to be in a hospital. Once you go to the hospital, you can either get treated, you need to get healed, you need to get delivered, and you need to go out there and be, we're supposed to be an army. Not hanging out in the hospital. Hospitals for new believers, or if somebody gets hurt, they come to the hospital, it's temporary. You don't live in a hospital. I know people on YouTube who live in the hospital. They've been heartbroken about their marriage for 20 years, and they're still going on and on and on. God can deliver you from that. Your husband died or wife died or whatever. You need to let the Lord heal you from it. You need to have forgive other people, whatever you need to do. That's what tonight is about. Tomorrow we'll talk about the end times. Tonight is tonight to have a new beginning with the Lord, to clean your plate, to clean the slate, to get right with God. That's what tonight is about. So tonight it's about repentance. And the biggest problem with most people is unforgiveness. You know, unforgiveness toward your mom, your dad, ex-husband, ex-wife, you know, dead husband, dead wife, children, whatever. Tonight is a night for repentance, forgiveness, and that's what the Lord wants us to do. The most important thing we can do, Jesus even said that very clearly when Peter asked him, how many times shall I forgive somebody? 7 times 7? Jesus said, you know, 70 times a day. And he tells a parable about, you know, the servant who owes a debt. And then he asks the master, please forgive me my debt. And the master says, okay, I'll forgive you your debt. Then he goes out. There's another servant that owes him, you know, like a dollar. He had owed the master $1,000. The master forgave him. He goes out and he tells the other servant, hey, you owe me a dollar. Give me the dollar. And the guy says, please forgive me. He says, no. He gets him thrown in jail until he can pay the dollar. And the master finds out. He punishes that guy and casts him into outer darkness. There's weeping and gnashing of teeth. And Jesus said, my heavenly Father, for all the people that are once saved, I always say, Jesus said, my heavenly Father will do the same thing to those who do not forgive their brother from your heart. So we have to forgive people. It's a big hindrance in the church, a big stumbling block to people. They have demonic activity in their life. A lot of times it's rooted in unforgiveness, a root of bitterness, a big one. So that's what I want to do tonight. Brothers and sisters, I want us to seek the Lord. I was going to start out with prayer. We need to do that. We need to pray, seek the Lord, ask the Lord to create us, to be sanctuaries, to purify us, to lead us in what we need to get right in our lives. So a lot of people's forgiveness. Other people, it's abuse of drugs, alcohol, whatever. You know, whatever's in your life. Pornography is probably the number one among men. In the modern day world, it's almost every brother I talk to is pornography. You know, it's just, you stumble into it. If you get on the internet, you're going to run into it. Not even trying. You go to, like, Fox News, and they got some link about some weight loss thing. You go there, next thing you know, it's taking you right to some naked pictures. That's what, it's all, it's the internet.
I had it pop up on my phone, and I watch other but Christian stuff.
Right.
And then there's some from Japan, pornography on it. I'm like,
so you have to not be actively, it's not like you're even looking for it. That's the thing about, that's why so many men fall into it. Because it's in your face.
Yeah.
Something that we have to be, you know, to be alert and be sober and be vigilant about, to stop it, you know, turn it off. So it's very hard for people, you know, to be on guard, but that's what we have to do. So that's another thing. And so, brothers and sisters, I ask you, let's pray. Let's pray. Let's worship the Lord. And I just invite you all, let's just begin to pray. You know, we don't have anybody to sing but me, but I was going to play my computer with some worship music. I didn't have... get it set up, but I invite you all, brothers and sisters, let's just pray right now and ask the Lord, I'll lead us to get started. I'm going to let you guys all pray individually, and we're just going to invite the Lord here to do something, and that's what it's all about. So I ask you, any agenda that you have, it's time to lay it at the Lord's feet. It's time to surrender all to Jesus. Stop carrying those things with you, those burdens. We got to lay our burdens at the Savior's feet. So let's worship the Lord. Hallelujah. Father, hallelujah, Father, we worship you, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord. The Lord, your word says the Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of your people, Lord God. Father, we just want to praise you and worship you and love you. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, hallelujah. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we bless your holy name. You deserve the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands in worship as we bless your holy name. For you are great. You do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. Yes, Lord. There is no one else like you. Hallelujah, Father. We invite you, Lord God. Lord, have your way in this place, Lord. Hallelujah. Lord, hallelujah, Lord, hallelujah, Lord. We come in agreement, Lord, even as your word said, how good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. It is like the oil that ran down Aaron's beard, even to the hem of his garments. Let that oil, Lord God, let the Spirit of the living God pour down upon us, Lord God. Have your way in this place, Lord, hallelujah. We all agree, Lord, have your way in us, Lord. Have your way in me. Lord, I give you my heart, I give you my soul. I live for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me. Yes, Lord. Lord, I give you my heart, give you my soul. Yes, Lord. I live for you alone, every breath that I take, every moment I'm awake. Lord, have your way in me. Hallelujah, Father, we invite you, Lord God. Yes, Lord. Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary, pure and holy unto Thee. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We pray it right now, Lord God. Prepare us, Lord God. Hallelujah, Father. We call upon You, Lord, and we ask You to forgive us of our sins in Jesus' name. We plead the blood of Jesus over this place. Hallelujah, Lord God. For You said righteousness exalts a nation. Lord, we invite You, Lord. You said those who hunger, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Yes. Lord, we believe right now in the name of Jesus, for Your righteousness to fill this place. Hallelujah, Lord God. We bless You, Lord. We bless You, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God. We just wait on You, Lord. We beseech Thee, Father, to have Your way in this place, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God. We honor You, Lord. We praise You, Lord. Yes, Lord. We're sorry, Lord, for the things we've made us. But it's all about You. It's all about You, Jesus. Yes, Lord. We're sorry, Lord, for the things we've made it. But it's all about You. It's all about You, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship. Because it's all about You. It's all about You, Jesus. I'm coming back to the heart of worship. Because it's all about You. It's all about You, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God Almighty. Yes, Lord. Father, we just believe, decree, and declare, Lord, that You are moving in this place, and Your Spirit is beginning to move among us. Yes, Lord. Yes. If we cast our cares upon You, You'll move. Hallelujah. I'm going to move among You. Hallelujah. I'm going to reign down on You. If You cast Your cares on me, hallelujah, Lord. We cast our cares upon You, Lord. We lay our burdens at the Savior's feet. We give You our worries, our strife, yes, our unforgiveness, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. We forgive any that we have anything against right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, help us to forgive and forget those who have wronged us, whether it be our parents, grandparents, cousins, brothers, sisters, husbands, wives, children, friends, co-workers. Lord, call those things to remembrance to us, Lord God, that we might repent of them, Lord God. Create within us, Lord, a pure heart, even as You did King David, Lord. And Lord, You said King David was a man after Your own heart because he wrote those songs, Lord. He worshipped You, hallelujah, in spirit and in truth. Lord, let us worship You in spirit and in truth. Create in us a pure heart. Yes. We worship You in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I came to worship You. Yes, Lord. I came to love You, Lord. Your holy name to praise. Yes, Lord. Oh, how I worship You. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, how we worship You. We came to love You, Lord, Your holy name to praise. Hallelujah. Oh, how we worship You. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We lift Your name on high. Yes, Lord. We love to sing Your praises. I'm so glad You're in my life. Hallelujah. I'm so glad You came to save us. Yes, Lord. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay, from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift Your name on high. Hallelujah, Lord God. We bless You, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We're not our own, but we've been bought with a price. Lord, You have a blood-bought right to reign over us. Yes. Yes, Lord. So why don't You come reign over me, Lord? Yes, Lord. You are all that I want. You are all that I needed. Open my heart you might come and reign over me, Lord. Yes, open your heart. I open my heart that you might come and reign over me, Lord. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah for those who hunger and thirst for you, Lord, that they would be filled. Lord, as you promised, we receive it in Jesus. Hallelujah. We receive it, Lord God, to be filled with your Spirit. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. We have come into this house, gathered in your name to worship you. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. We have come into this house, gathered in your name to worship you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we bless you. We bless you, Lord God. Yes, Lord. Have your way in this place, Lord. Yes, Lord. We surrender. I surrender all. Yes. All to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Father, we just receive right now, Lord. As you begin to move among us, Lord, we just receive in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we praise you right now, Lord God. You are a good God. You are the mighty God, Lord. You are holy, Lord God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Lord, we receive, Lord, the holiness, Lord. The holiness of your Spirit to be upon us, Lord. Lord, we surrender all to you, Lord. Create in us a pure heart. Lord, we plead the blood of Jesus over our families, over our lives, over our minds, over our bodies, over our futures, Lord God, and over our past. For you said that as far as the east is from the west, so shall our sins be from us. Lord, you said if we confess our sins, you are just and faithful to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Lord, you said if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek my face, and turn from their wicked ways, I would hear from heaven. I will forgive their sins, and I will heal their land. Hallelujah, Lord God. We all individually turn from our wicked ways, Lord God. We call upon you, Lord, in repentance in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord God. Lord, we know that the enemy has tried to stop us, Lord God, and stop your people. We know we've got the victory through the blood of Jesus Christ. We've got the victory through the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. But the enemy has been trying to be a thorn in our flesh, just like he was to the Apostle Paul. But Lord, thy grace gives us the overcoming victory over all the power of the enemy. For he is under our feet by the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, the name above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee shall bow, and every tongue shall confess of things in heaven and things on the earth and things under the earth. Hallelujah. And every tongue will confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God. We've got complete and total victory right now over all the power of the enemy. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We've got the victory right now tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We got the victory. There's some body in here. You feel it by spirit? They're bound. They're bound. They need to be set free. Hallelujah. I ask you, that person right now in my spirit, I feel it, that they would humble themselves. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They would humble themselves. Bow the knee. Hallelujah. Jesus said, unless you become like a little child, you cannot enter the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. And I pray this person would not continue to resist the Spirit of the Lord. Lord, I pray for them right now in the name of Jesus. They've been a stiff-necked person, but I pray right now, by the grace of God, they would obtain mercy today in the name of Jesus Christ. They would surrender all to the Lord and become as a little child, become a born-again Christian and start out at zero, at day one, as a newborn baby in Christ. Hallelujah. No matter how old you are. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's a new beginning. Offered by the Lord. We thank you, Father, that you are the God of new beginnings. The God of the new mercies. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. New every morning, great is thy faithfulness, O Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. The steadfast love of the Lord His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning, great is thy faithfulness. Hallelujah, Lord God. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord God, we bless you. As we gather, may your spirit move within us. And as we gather, may we glorify your name. Yes, Lord. Yes, as our hearts begin to worship, we'll be glad because we came. Hallelujah. Lord, we invite you, Lord God, to have your way in this place. Lord, we surrender to you now. We seek you now, Lord God. As I've already given them the word that you wanted them to put off all their pretenses, all of their outward shell appearances, and all the vanities and things of this world to be put off as we come in to receive, Lord God, from you. Lord, I gave them that word that you would have them have to put off religion, put off self-righteousness, to put off vanities of the mind, and get away from religion and have a personal walk with you, Lord. Hallelujah. For the Lord desires each one of us to walk with him in the cool of the day. Hallelujah. That's what it's all about, that we would walk with the Lord in the cool of the day. And we would come to the garden alone while the dew is still on the roses. The voice I hear falling on my ears, the sound of God supposes. And he walks with me and he talks with me. And he tells me I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry there. None other has ever known. Hallelujah. 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 I pray I was going to play my music. They didn't give me this table. I want to play the music and have us continue to worship the Lord. And anyone that wants to be prayed for will come forward. They did give me my table, but I'll set it up. I still see one or two people in here that is, hey, sister, that are not entered into the worship with us. One or two people. I mean, I know when you go to a church, you see lots of people, but everyone that came here should come here for that. If you don't want to enter worship, why? You know, that's what we're here for, to enter into worship of the Lord. You know, there's a unity in the Spirit. As I quoted from you, that really the theme for revival, you always hear 2 Chronicles 7:14, which I quoted. You know, my people are called by my name, humble themselves and praise, and turn from their wicked ways and seek my face. But the other one, Psalm 133, how good and pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in unity. It is even as the oil that ran down Aaron's beard, even to the hem of his robe. Of course, Jesus is our high priest, not Aaron. And the oil is the Spirit of God. So when we're in unity and the oil is coming from the head, Jesus Christ, this is where we get revival. We have unity in the Spirit. So whenever you have a gathering and people aren't in unity, then you don't have a bond of peace and unity in the Spirit. You know, someone is grieving the Holy Spirit. Of course, we can override that with our fervent prayer. The Bible says the fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. James chapter 5. So we can do that. But I know that I can feel it in my spirit and I can see there's one or two people in here. Believe it or not, everywhere you go, there's always someone that seems to have an assignment to do that. It's the way it goes. But we have victory in the name of the Lord. And I invite everyone in here to enter into worship with us. You'll be blessed by God. God's going to bless us more and more as we come in unity in the Spirit. We're unified because we have one Master. The Bible says, how can two walk together except they be in agreement? Amos 3:3. So if I'm following Jesus, you're following Jesus, we're walking together. We have the same Master. So we're here to honor Him. As I say, no matter what denomination you came from and all that kind of stuff, we have one Master. The Lord has made room for all of us to have different beliefs about pre-tribulation, rapture, or whatever. It's not what it's about. This supersedes all that. If you're a born-again Christian, we have one Master. We're here to please Him, to minister to Him. You know, a lot of times in churches, somebody will get up and sing, and it's a performance. And the people that are clapping. But when you're singing and worshiping, we're supposed to be ministering to the Lord. We're doing it to Him. And then when someone preaches, it's like the Lord is ministering back to us through that prophetic word or whatever you get. That's the Lord ministering to us. Or when His Spirit moves, He's ministering into our hearts and all that, right? But we're provoking Him by worshiping Him. We're calling the Lord and He responds. He says, call upon me and I'll answer you and show you great and mighty things that you know not. That's God's phone number in case you didn't know it. Jeremiah 33:3. Call upon me and I will answer you. God promises. But many people, I see you guys are worshiping some, but we're not calling upon Him. It says the fervent prayer of a righteous man of God's mind. So fervently, to fervently pray. Like Jesus in the Garden of Gethsemane, right? He was fervently praying. It says, you know, he was sweating so much it looked like blood. He's just sweating and like in labor. Fervently praising and praying the Lord. But every church, even in this group, there's still a couple of people in here that's like, well, what's the point? Let's worship the Lord. Let's praise the Lord, right? People came here for thirsting for the Lord. Let's have it. Praise God. Hallelujah. So I'm going to play this music. And if anybody wants to sing a song and cheer, you can do it right now. See if I want to sing. somebody want to pray? Are we going to pray all individually, but someone can lead us in a prayer too if they want to? I'm setting this up. Somebody wants to, or you just want to wait on me? Okay, fine. I just got some little speakers, and they're supposed to have a table for me, but they didn't. I'm just going to play some music through my stereo as we can pray for a little while. And then I can, anybody wants to be prayed for, like his brother wants to be baptized in the Holy Spirit, I want to pray for him. Or people that want to pray for healing or to be used by God. You know, when I'm in the Philippines and I do revivals at churches, I mean, there's times when there's real revival, but a lot of times when I do revival, I get up there and preach, God wants to use you and all that. And God wants to, you know, win the Philippines to the Lord. And then people come to the altar and say, hey, can you pray for me because, you know, my husband will stop drinking? Or can you pray for me for this, that, and the other? Like one out of 100 will say, here am I, send me. And that was the message, was here am I, send me. One out of 100 will say, yeah, I want to be used by God. 99% of the people, it's about something else. I know we all have problems. And I'll pray with you about that. Either tonight or tomorrow. It doesn't matter. It's what God's about too, right? Like I said, we're not supposed to be living in the hospital. Even though the church is a hospital, we're supposed to be in the battlefield. God wants us to be healed right now, not for years and years and years. You know, I got divorced 25 years ago, and you know I'm still suffering from it. No, you chose to keep staying. You know, taking antibiotics for 25 years. You know, and going to counseling, or whatever you're doing. Prozac. It's time for you to get healed, get delivered, and go back out there, serve God, because God's bigger than your problem, whatever it is. Mm-hmm. That's people's attitude. We've got to be an army. We've got to be an army. So I'm trying to hook up and play some worship music while we're sitting here. I'm sorry. They're supposed to have a table, but of course they didn't. So that's what I mean. Little speakers. You guys want to be prayed for afterwards? We'll do it. Let's start some music. I thought they were going to bring a table, but they sure didn't do it.
No.
What are you going to do?
They had to see management for a table.
Isn't that something? Well, I'm trying to start.
He's one of the chairs.
That's what I'm going to do. But I just got these little old speakers. It's not really, because I'm on the road, it's hard to, you know. So I'm trying to place a little bit of music here. Just the worship music or something, so I can be praying with people. We don't have a praise and worship team. Anything like that. When I go to churches, that's the thing about it. You go to a church, they have music. But here, we don't have that. So, I don't know. Let's do the best that we can. Use a feedback on that. Sure. Connect in here. Play some song worship music. Try that. Does anybody have any comments or questions before we do this? We're going to be praying and seeking the Lord. And if anybody wants to be prayed for, they can come forward. Person, you know, as we go along, I'll come around and pray with you and come forward.
You can sit down if you need to. Pray with everybody. I'll just play this music in the background. Every person just keep, you know, praying on your own. The Lord leads you. Can y'all hear a little bit? Okay. You want to come in the front, please?
Yeah.
You're not really. Imagine that. Worshiping the Lord, because I'm asking the Lord, it's going to move in here in this place. I know the Lord's doing something. He's removing the chaff in our lives and in this room, and He's working on us. He's working right now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord. We give you the glory. We give you the glory, Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's just invite Him. Glory, glory, glory! Hallelujah. Glory of the living God. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, send down your glory. Yes, Lord, we receive your glory. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Yes, you are worthy, worthy, worthy. Holy, holy, holy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.